Connor Fields is an Olympic gold medalist and world champion BMX racer. To understand what makes him one of the best in his sport, we're pushing him to the max in our series of physical tests.
Nearly 60 centimeters.
Hi, I'm Lolo Jones, and welcome to Anatomy of a BMX Racer. Joining me in Las Vegas is U.S. star Connor Fields. Are you ready for this?
Let's do it.
Come on.
Ready, watch the gate.
To be an elite BMX racer, you need power, strength, and balance. And these qualities have to be aligned with a fearless approach to racing. At the Olympic Games Rio 2016, everything came together for Connor as he reached the pinnacle of his sport. Olympic gold was his.
I train 6 days a week, and I have done for 10 plus years. It's dedication. It's not taking time off. It's going to the gym when you don't want to. It's going to ride when you might have other things you'd rather do instead. It's just an ultimate dedication day in and day out to build up the body of an Olympic athlete.
To examine Connor's physiological makeup, we've brought him to one of the world's leading human performance institutes. We're going to look behind the stats of this elite sportsman and see how he shapes up away from the comfort of the BMX track.
First up, we're gonna look at Connor's body composition with the DEXA scan.
Okay, Connor, this is our DEXA scanner. So this is gonna measure your body composition. Someone like a BMXer like yourself, it's important that we can generate those big amounts of power through the pedals. So we're gonna look at how much muscle you have, how much body fat you have, and we're gonna be interested to see what those results look like.
Sounds good.
Yeah. 5 minutes, we'll see what happens. His percent body fat was 17%, which is in the top 50th percentile for his age range. And as an elite athlete, you would hope and expect that's where he's going to be. I think it's interesting when you compare body fat percentages between sports. Connor is taking his body around on a bike rather than having to propel or locomote it himself as runners and sprinters need to do. So that allows him to essentially have a little bit more weight, and some of that will be body fat. And it also gives him some momentum in those starts as he's accelerating down the start ramp. So 17% is an outstanding number, and we would expect that for an elite athlete like himself.
Connor, all that pedaling in your sport, you have to have strong legs.
I mean, I never skip leg day.
Well, this next test, we're gonna see how strong those legs are.
Let's do it.
All right.
The main muscles at work in BMX racing are the calves, the hamstrings, the glutes, and the quadriceps.
I look at my body like it's a tool, and I take care of it, and I do everything I can to make sure that it's in the best shape it can be.
Okay, Connor, this test is our counter movement jump. It's largely a measure of lower body power, which for a BMXer like yourself, this should be your wheelhouse, man. This is where you've got to excel. So listen, we're gonna step onto this force plate. This is gonna measure how much force you put into the ground. We're then gonna jump for maximal height. We'll be able to understand how high you're jumping using this technology. So we're gonna see what we can do. In 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, up.
Let's go.
Good, hold. When we looked at the data, he had a vertical jump around 60 centimeters, which is a really, really impressive number. If we look at other sports like basketball and volleyball, they might be in the 80 to 90 centimeter range. So 60 is a really impressive number and demonstrates that Connor, as a BMXer, is a true strength power athlete with lots of ability to generate force very quickly, propelling him off the ground.
Our next test is an isometric mid-thigh pull. Let's see how he does.
The isometric mid-thigh pull is a measurement of whole body maximal strength. Essentially, Connor has to pull on that bar as hard as he can. The bar doesn't move, and any effort that he produces goes straight into our force plates, and we can measure the force that he produces in the ground.
Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go!
Pull, let's go! Pull, pull, you pull. Got this! Come on.
Let's go! Let's go!
Let's go!
The mid-thigh pull, I enjoyed doing that one. I've never had 6 seconds feel like that long before. It was the longest 6 seconds I've ever had.
Connor, you know that you're actually supposed to like rip the bar out.
I tried. Maybe the next time.
Let's think about the data, just looking at some of those results. really exciting, as would have expected in a strength power athlete like yourself. That was about 3,500 newtons for the total force, which is a great number. If we put that into kind of kilos, it's about 3.8 times your own body weight that you're pulling off the ground. So that's really exciting. If we look at Olympic weightlifters, which is that's all they do, they're probably up in the 5 times your own body weight region. If you look at marathon runners, they're barely lifting 1.5 times your own body weight off the floor.
I was definitely impressed with his thigh pull results, but I was more impressed that he had official Olympic weightlifting shoes. This is like he came to work with a briefcase. So let's take a break from testing. You go to your first Olympics and you got 7th, correct?
Yep.
And then you go to another Olympics and you win gold. Like, what? Like, tell us.
Well, the craziest thing was the difference of the two Olympics. So going into London, I think I was world ranked number 2. I'd been winning a bunch of races that year. I was on fire. I was one of the favorites to win. I was the number 1 seed in the final. You know, I had first lane selection. It was kind of all coming together. And I completely blew it. Interestingly enough, going into Rio was the complete opposite. I broke my wrist 4 months before.
Dang.
I only made the team on a discretionary nomination. I almost couldn't race. The doctor couldn't legally clear me to ride. I had to make my own decision. I made the final. I was the number 6 seed this time around, but I knocked it out of the park in the final.
And won gold.
And I won gold. So it was kind of two completely different lead-ups and then two completely opposite outcomes.
Wow, that's some great motivation. I mean, I'm fired up. Well, I'm not doing the testing, but you are, so let's get back to some more testing.
Let's do it.
This next test should be right in your comfort zone. We're putting you on another bike.
Let's party.
We're gonna test your anaerobic power skills.
Let's go, come on.
All right.
We're going to see how efficient Connor is at powering his leg muscles for 10 seconds.
Okay, Connor, next test right in your wheelhouse as a BMX racer. This is our maximal alactic power test. It's looking at the maximum amount of metabolic power that your legs can produce into the bike. This is gonna be really similar to what you do in your race, so we're expecting great performance here.
I hope I don't let you down.
Don't let yourself down, that's what it comes down to. All right, 2, 1, go!
Push, push, push!
All right, good job, Connor. Real brutal test, that one, for sure. But obviously, as a BMX rider, we've got to make sure that we're performing well on this test.
I would hope that I would hope this would be my best test.
Absolutely. So when we look at the data, as expected, truly, truly outstanding. You hit a peak power output of 2,300 watts, which is fantastic. That's gonna really maximize that start at the start ramp. The interesting one that we really look at is the wattage per kilo of body weight, right? That was right around 19.5 watts per kilogram of muscle. And again, as an elite cyclist, that's a fantastic number. If we look at our mixed martial artists here in the UFC, they're normally about 15. An endurance runner is gonna be way down 11, 10. So, you know, 19, 20, you know, watts per kilo of body weight. Fantastic amounts of power that it's producing. So fantastic numbers.
Yeah, Duncan just lied this whole time. He just made up all those stats. You essentially just powered the UFC headquarters for the next month. So that wasn't really a test. We just wanted to save on some electricity.
You're welcome, I'll send you an invoice.
There we go. I think when people think about the BMX, they don't always consider it the most physical sport. They're riding around on a bike, it's a lifestyle attitude that BMXers often possess. But I think the data that we got from Connor today in the lab really showed how exceptional his physiology is, both from a strength perspective, but also from a power production perspective.
I think it just goes to show the level of his professionalism.
Go, come on, up.
Let's go. He's equipped, he's well trained, and he's like, you see him turn his game face on, and he's just a highly professional elite athlete.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
BMXers, massive amounts of respect. Those guys have got great physiology, and Connor today demonstrated what an Olympic gold medalist BMXer can do.
I'm Connor Fields, signing out.